Hello, Gulls fans. Welcome to another Friday night Gulls Rewind. You voted on this one. This was the Twitter poll that we put up on Monday, April 13th, and we're reflecting on Star Wars night. And real quick, we want to remind you here about our fine sponsor, California Coast Credit Union, our great sponsor of our Gulls Rewind. Keep in mind, you can also interact with us during the course of this rewind. Hashtag Gulls Rewind is what you want to use in order to interact and talk about the game. You can tweet us. You can hit us up on Instagram. We'll be very active during this as well. But one thing I want to talk about first is, fans, you can win a Star Wars night jersey through Twitter by wearing your best Star Wars themed costumes. Send us your tweet at SDGullsAHL, and we'll pick the best one, and you can win a Star Wars themed jersey. So with that said, let's bring in BJ McPherson. We're both sporting our playoff beards right now as best we can. And I think this team was bound for it. And this is one of those games that certainly made a statement early in the season back in November.
Well, back in November, this was one of the days I was waiting for. You know, we've got it now that we don't have hockey right now. But back then, for Star Wars night, was one of the nights the Gulls really had a loaded lineup. This is one of the nights you had to be on your A game for Coach Kevin Dineen to put you in the lineup. And this is one of the nights you and I'd look at each other and go, we look on paper and we go, this is a pretty deep lineup. And tonight's one of those nights when we get to play the Ontario Reign.
Well, what are some things that we can look forward to during the course of this game? I mean, there's a few moments that stood out in my mind, but I won't take your thunder. I'll let you roll with it.
Well, again, this is one of those games, a rivalry game. The game opens up and it's really physical right away, but that's where the dominance and the depth of the Gulls comes out. And I think Maxime Comtois, you know, the big first rounder for the Ducks, he was the one that opened it up in my eyes in one of his better starting games of the season, physically, and then his passing ability. Him and Justin Clues putting that pass tape to tape to go down for a shorthanded goal, and that was right around the time of the year where the shorthanded goals just started to spiral out of control.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, such a good angled pass off the boards to get Clues in stride. I mean, those are things that you look for when you're shorthanded or just 5-on-5 in general that's going to generate some good opportunities. Of course, you had good offense. Chris Weidman was contributing during the course of this game, something else to look forward to. But, you know, we talked about it last week, and we're going to talk about it again this week. The big man in net, Anthony Stolarz.
Anthony Stolarz, 29 shots, 28 saves. You know, he looks back in a game like this, a 5-1 win for the team, but all he think about is that goal that went in, and it doesn't matter if there was two Anthony Stolarz in. He wasn't stopping that one, but I'll tell you what, again, that was another one of the games where we saw the dominance of Anthony Stolarz come out.
And then also the dominance of the defense that kind of showed through in the third period. I mean, that's something else to look forward to, limiting the shots for Ontario, and then the Gulls respond by getting a trio of guys that had a lot of good shots of their own.
Yeah, that's a big one. The Gulls had over 35 shots in the game, and that's a big thing for the Gulls this year. But between three players, I think it was like Daniel Sprong, Kiefer Sherwood, and I believe Justin Clues, they had 16 shots between the three of them, and I don't think we've had a game since then where we've had three players put up 16 shots.
Well, without further ado, we're going to bring you that game again. Fans, remember, you can interact with us. Hashtag Gulls Rewind. We'll encourage you again, dress up in your favorite Star Wars costume, tweet it at us, at SDGullsAHL, and you can win a Star Wars night jersey. So we'll take you back to Star Wars night. Fans, enjoy the game. This is Gulls Rewind, presented by California Coast Credit Union.
force be with you.
Always.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your San Diego Gulls! Fans, it is now time for the night's ceremonial puck drop. Please welcome 9-year-old Braden Heath, who was accompanied by some of his favorite Star Wars characters. On Star Wars night, all proceeds from the Star Wars jersey auction will benefit Rady Children's Hospital's auxiliary and help kids just like Braden. All right, Braden, whenever you're ready, drop that puck. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Braden Heath with our ceremonial puck drop.
Spin it back.
Balls in their whites, traveling from right to left. Carrick on the opening faceoff. He wins it straight back. DeLeo nudges it to Hockenpah. We're underway for Saturday Night Hockey in San Diego. Leo tries an angled shot off the near corner. It's hit the side of the cage. Bjornfoot intercepts the pass. Will scamper out to center. Puck gets swung in along the right wing side by Boma. He got delivered by a body check from Benoit, but uses the puck's momentum to get it in. Big board battle that Sam Carrick pulls away. Five straight games for a goal from him. Lead it up to DeLeo, who lightly taps it into the Ontario zone. 35 seconds gone. Kiefer Sherwood's the first one to it. It squirts free to Cal Peterson, and he'll freeze and hold on for a whistle. Tonight's scratches for San Diego: Corey Trapp, Scott Moldenhauer, Devin Sidorov, Andrew Podorowski, Ryan Johnson, and Luke Gazdik. Earlier today, we learned that Scott Ruggiero is called up from Tulsa. He's also in the lineup. And scratch for the Ontario Reign: Daniel Brickley, Martin Furk, who's injured, Chaz Redekop, and Boko Imama.
Well, Ruggiero in the lineup tonight. That's one of the keys of the game. Defensive zone coverage. Eliminate the giveaways tonight.
Whiteman with a chance. Turned away. Rebound. Justin Kloos trying to pound it home. And Cal Peterson gloves it and hangs on.
Yeah, Kloos is looking up into the rafters. He's got pretty quick hands, and he took that puck from behind the net on the goal line. His skates are behind the goal line and try to stuff that one in. Quick hands from behind the net. Kloos picks it up and he just misses it. I think Cal Peterson was able to get his other hand on that puck. Took his hand off his stick there and used it as an extra weapon.
The Reign win the faceoff. Puck goes straight up in the air. Nobody knows where it is. It hit two sticks at one time. Clegg and Kloos battle now in the corner. Lundestrom jumps in. He'll slap it behind the net, rimmed over to the far corner. Weidman, he's got number three on his back, and I'm starting to learn that that's for a reason. Two straight games of 3 points. Back to Lundestrom at the point, and his drive sails wide. I mentioned the scratches just a moment ago. Boko Imama out. We'll touch on that momentarily as a cross-ice feed gets blocked in the near boards, controlled by Kloos. So, BJ, what does that mean to you that Boko Imama's out of lineup? He's a powerful guy.
Yeah, that's a big power forward that the Reign don't have tonight. They got to change their style of game.
Doty's the only one that was back in the lineup after a good effort last night, where that line drove some good scoring chances halfway through the contest. We're almost two gone, no score. Sprung with an attempt just a moment ago that caught some oohs and ahs, but it was blocked and tipped away. Puck dumped into the goal zone. Stolarz out to Benoit. He gets pressured by coverage on the forecheck by Sodergren. Benoit recoups. He'll go to the far boards. It's tipped out. Broadhurst, one hand on his stick, trying to get it to Sprung, but it was jumped on by Strand and played straight up the gut. Worked in by Anderson. Now Sodergren, wrist shot. Stolarz with the save. He'll freeze it and hang on.
In front of that net, Jack Opaka in a kind of little pushing match there. The big forward comes back and he's an extra body in front of that net. Stolarz does the smart thing with that shot in his chest. He wasn't going to be able to play it very well, so he takes the whistle.
Jack Opaka, big body indeed, 6'3", 192. And I think that's pretty generous on the 192 in terms of cutting down the weight. I think he's got to be tipping over 200. He's got some solid muscle on him. Reign won a face-off. Durzi sends it wide. Moran in a foot race with Anderson for the puck on the far boards. Puck slung out to the point and a shot turned away by the stick of Stolarz. And out of play it goes. 2.5 gone in the first frame.
Again, a really smart play by Stolarz. 20 seconds ago, he freezes it off his chest. This second time, it's a shot right along the ice. He can play it any way he wants, but he takes it and he makes sure to deflect it high over the glass. The Gulls wait for the change by the rain. The Gulls then counter.
California Coast Credit Union presents this game. They are San Diego's oldest financial institution with over 20 branch locations, a shared branch network of 60 area locations, and 30,000 free ATMs nationwide. You touched on it there, the home ice advantage. It lies in the chess match of line combinations and matching lines. And sometimes coaches care about that, sometimes they don't. They're more concerned with their own bench.
Yeah, you're right. And sometimes when coaches do it so much, it disrupts a game for a player. Sometimes you miss a line.
And that can get in someone's head. Even the coach's head, for that matter. So you're right. Sometimes they do it. But I'd say, I don't know, more often than not, no.
The big thing is defensive zone faceoffs. That's the big one I noticed. They play that one percentage probably over 50%.
Yanni Hakanpää leaves it for Benoit in his own zone. Played up to the left wing for Kiefer Sherwood. He'll hack it in. Ball slowly beginning a line change. Puck worked out of the rain zone. It misses the second year forward, Rempel. And no icing call. Seeloff gets there before it crosses over the goal line. He'll send it to the right wing boards for Klus. Tipped over the line by Lundestrom. Comtois dances around one. Left for Weidman, and a chance hits the post and cleared away.
Comtois puts a pass behind his back, and I don't know how Weidman gets so much wood on that shot, but he barrels it off the post.
Boy, he has got to have one of the quickest releases I maybe have ever seen a defenseman have.
He didn't move those hands very much, but it looked like a slap shot, but it was a wrist shot.
And boy, does that one snap on net quickly. Puck fired back into the Ontario zone. Klus behind the net. His attempt to center gets blocked off the skate of Ledoux, and it's hustled out on the left wing side. Södergren pushes it across the blue line and dumped down further. First one on it, Ruggiero. He'll leave it to the corner for Hakanpää, who gets bodied up, but he'll squirm free and slap it along to Justin Klus. Klus worked out by Ruggiero and cleared into the Ontario zone. Leg after in the near corner of his own territory. Couldn't get it around Alex Broadhurst. Pietola and Sprong jump in, worked free. Ruggiero whistles one wide. And it's poked off the far boards by Ruggiero into the Ontario bench with 4.5 gone of our first no score.
Ruggiero, as he comes up from the ECHL, takes a big shot there. I like the way he shoots it on the short side. If you miss that net on the far side, it's going to wrap all the way around and come out. Ruggiero shooting on the smart side.
And boy, did he get all of that too.
He was able to walk it in from the blue line, standing back, making sure defense first. When that puck squirted out, he came in, and after taking that shot, he knew what to do. He was back on the point.
22-year-old defenseman picked up 3 points, 1 goal, 2 assists, and 14 contests with the Tulsa Oilers. Skating in his first year pro out of Lake Superior State. Puck worked down the ice by the rain. Boma trying to cut to the net. Couldn't get a shot, and then another one by Doty goes wide. Puck jammed towards the slot, poked out to the blue line. Strand fades away. He tried to get one on the cage, but Kopacka blocks it. He'll sling it out to center. Dosti and Moram, 2-on-1. Dosti around Peterson, trying to put it in. He stops it somehow and freezes.
Well, as Dossie's coming down, he's got Moran on the right side. Dossie 100% wants to make that pass, but there's just no lane, no way to make it. He runs out of real estate a little bit, and Cal Peterson gets that big glove down on the ice again and is able to stop it coming through. The Gulls get that scoring chance, but they're a little muddy in their own zone. Only about 5 minutes into this first period, and they don't have that start they've had yesterday. They've got to pick it up a little bit, and they've got to crisp up a little bit in their own zone. They've already given it up a couple times. Want to eliminate or limit the giveaways in their own zone.
Well, limit, you could use that word too. Right now, the Rain have the lead in the shots 3-2, which is actually a little surprising. I don't think Dosti's attempt there registered as a shot on goal, but it was a good heads-up play. You know, I don't think that was something you would have saw last year from Alex Dosti, was that poise, the ability to try to take it down to the goal line, and as Peterson was out of the net, tuck it back in.
Experience, poise. They come together. Alex Dossi showing a lot more of it this year.
Puck cleared into the goal zone. Seeloff off the far boards. Bjornfoot holds it in. He sent it down low, and it's rejected away in an offside whistle. We'll send us to a stoppage. San Diego Gulls have partnered with McDonald's. Whenever the Gulls win a home game, you score large fries for a buck the following day. Just download the McDonald's app and wait for that sweet taste of victory. Faceoff will drop outside the Gulls bench. Anderson Dolan against Lundestrom. Lorraine win it. Cleared into the San Diego zone. Hakanpaa moves it behind the net. Lundestrom to Comtois. Backhanded safely out to the neutral zone for Kloos. He gets bumped two different directions. Rimple and Strand. Puck knocked free for Jani Hakanpaa. He'll play it to Lundestrom. One touch. Right back to Hakanpaa. Fed up to Comtois at center. Puck was knuckling on him. He tried to clear it in, but it jumped over his stick and only could float it about 5 feet in front of him. Lorraine will grab possession. Rimple on the near boards, right in front of the penalty boxes, gave it up. Regained by Anderson Dolan, and he'll slap it up to Rimple. He'll break it in with speed, turn it down low on Stolarz, who easily moves it aside to the corner. Rimple felt the heavy heat of Simon Benoit's check after he let go of the shot. Meanwhile, behind the play, Lundestrom got taken down.
Lundestrom took a big hit to the head down in the corner. He's going off, not looking too well there. Not sure who was on Ontario. Ontario's playing a gritty game right now, really taking away time and space. The Gulls are having trouble getting their speed.
Well, it's that classic road game as the puck gets worked in along the right wing side. Södergren hits the brakes against Seeloff, and then Seeloff with one hand puts him down on the ice. But the puck scooted across behind the net, centered, and Stolarz makes a save with the blocker. Sprong can't get it out. Weidman will backpedal to his goal line. He's got his head up looking for an outlet pass. He'll find Broders. Now Sprong as he cuts through center. He'll break it in over the line, chip it down low to the corner. First one on it, however, is the Ontario Reign defenseman forward Sutter, who plays it out to center ice, and it's chipped further along to Boma. Puck work down low as Hakanpaa will dig it free from his own territory. Played out to center ice, just hit the back of Kopaka's skate. He was trying to stream up ice for a chance. Instead, it's knocked away. 12:15 remaining, first period, no score. Haven't had a shot in a while. Jack Kopaka will weave it through center. He'll get it to Moran, who drives it into the attacking zone. Moran scoots away from a check of Ledoux. But the puck gets taken away by the veteran defenseman. Not out. Moran, great job to keep it alive. But Kupari was there in his direction to knock it free, and it's cleared back to the goal zone. Down low under 12 remaining of the first period. Still no score, and still haven't had a shot in about 3-4 minutes.
The last 3-4 minutes, the game's been played on the top of the circle from the Gulls all the way down to the Reign. It's been a neutral ice game in the last couple minutes.
Moran skates it into the attacking zone. He's pushed off the far boards, and it's worked back out. Puck dumped into the San Diego zone, 11 and a half remaining. Blues tips it out on the far boards. Gulls will head to the bench on a line change. Here's some good news. Isaac Lundestrom out there blazing around, BJ.
Well, that's what you like to see. You take a hit once in a while, you rub it off, and you get back out in the ice.
Puck worked in on Peterson. He'll keep it alive, though. I thought he might have covered that one. He'll play it to Strand. Off the far boards, not out, kept in. A shot blocked. It's lying in the slot. Collected by the Reign and carried out by Doty. He'll play it up to Kupari. Couldn't work himself around a check of Seeloff and Drew. Gulls can't get it out, though. Kept in. It's worked back down low by Stanton. He'll play it behind the net. Tried to go to Kupari. It's touched by the Gulls. And you have a whistle that'll halt our action.
High stick called. It's just going to be a face-off outside. The Gulls right now, they've got to pick it up a little bit. They're getting lucky. Ontario's coming blazing.
We'll take a break. No score. 10:46 remaining of the first. You're listening to the Gulls Audio Network. We're back to the Pechanga Arena. The San Diego Gulls all knotted up with the Ontario Reign. No score. San Diego wins a faceoff back in their own zone. Chase DeLeo gets a pass at the goal line. He is pressured, swallowed up, turned over. Trying to cut to the net to get a chance was Boma, but he's forced off the biscuit at the last second. Sherwood out to center, Carrick partial break. He gets caught up to by Ledoux and forced to the corner. DeLeo jumps to it. He'll go to Carrick behind the net. His centering pass gets it rejected by Sutter and out.
Carrick was pretty much standing flat-footed when he picked up that puck. Ledoux flying back. Carrick tried to get a play off there. Did the smart thing by keeping the puck deep and not just throwing it away.
Sherwood fires it in the attacking zone. He'll go after it himself. Play it to Benoit, who carries it down low. He'll center far wing. And a one-timer gets let go by Lundestrom, but it sails high and wide, and Hakanpää tracks it down. 10 minutes remaining in our first period. No score, and shots very, very low. 4-3 favoring Ontario. Kempe drives to the net, and Stolarz turns it away. Hakanpää behind the net. He gets flattened off the puck, but extra support. Lundestrom will play it back to Hakanpää, who regains his footing. Now Benoit up to Klus, who grazes through center. Blues fades off to the right wing into the attacking zone. He gets forced off the puck. Just tried to move it behind the net, and Anderson Dolan's there to tag him with a check. Klus gets back up. He'll track down Kempe behind the net, who moves it off to the near wing for Stanton. He'll scoot it through center ice, tried to go to Rempel, broken up. Gulls return it back in the attacking zone, but Klus was forced offside, brought it back in. 9:09 left of the first, no score. This is the Gulls Audio Network.
Fans, it's time for the California Coast Credit Union Star Wars race. Are you guys ready? Get set! Go! Oh, looks like the Millennium Falcon is in the lead.
Back at the Pechanga Arena, no score, 9:09 remaining. Alex Broadhurst, Blake Pietola, Daniel Sprong out for San Diego. And a face-off win for the Reign. Puck gets tipped out of play.
This is pretty much the new line for the Gulls this whole season. These three guys put together, Broadhurst out there, Pietola. These are the guys that have to get some goals going for the Gulls. You got to have four lines going. This is a big line for the Gulls tonight. Daniel Sprong, these are three guys that alone can have 20 goals each this season.
Yeah, you're right about that one. And don't forget, Blake Pietola, last year when he was with Binghamton, he was a guy who was darn near a point per game. And I want to say Broadhurst has found some resurgence here in San Diego. Not saying that he wasn't good prior, but I just see some new life in his step.
Well, the best thing I like about Broadhurst is it's defense first, and after that the offense comes, but he's a shutdown centerman.
And he's got a 4-game point streak heading into tonight's game. Still a lot of time left. Daniel Sprong couldn't dance his way across Dursey. Played up to Sodergren. Now Sutter with a wrist shot as soon as they stepped into the zone. And Anthony Stolarz comes up with a stop.
Well, Sutter gets that one in the neutral zone, and Daniel Sprong needs to make a decision. I either dump it in or I get my body with that puck over the blue line. You can't lose a puck 5 feet going on the offense, because in that neutral zone, a team like Ontario, they're going to turn it around in the neutral zone, and Sutter's going to take that scoring chance, and Stolarz bury them out of that one.
Faceoff will drop to the left of Stolarz. Alex Dosti will draw against Kupari. Faceoff win by Kupari. Clegg, snapshot, just wide of the net. Hakanpää to the far boards after it. Send it behind the net for Benoit. And clear down the ice. That one will go for an icing call with 8:03 remaining here in our first period. Still no score, quite a difference from last night. San Diego coming into this one, winning 6 of their last 7. And on the flip side of that, the Ontario Reign have only won 2 of their last 7.
That's the little things it starts with, and Dosti on the faceoff. Again, you don't have to win them all, but you can have a faceoff in your own zone won cleanly. Fight for it 50-50 at worst.
Sutter will get the boot on the draw. And he's pleading his case, but he won't win.
He won't, but that's a bonus for the Gulls. Sutter on his backhand is a 70% winner.
Oh, yeah, you're right about that one. And for those of you that might be new to hockey or not know the faceoff stats, when you get 55% on a faceoff, that's pretty good. 70 is outrageous.
And on his backhand, Sutter's pretty good.
Yeah, he is. Say one thing I've noticed since Benoit has the puck behind his own net. Got a quick chance to talk about this. Sam Carrick this year has turned into a faceoff specialist, I feel. Puck gets turned over. Anthony Stolarz with the stop. He didn't move. He had the angle cut down, and he knew it. And basically just let the rain forward pop it right into his equipment from Boma.
Well, I got to call it the way I see it, and it's sloppy right now. The Gulls have full possession of the puck in their own zone. This is one of the keys to the game. Limit the turnovers. Well, when you have full possession of that puck, you can't be giving it up to this Ontario team. Right now, the Gulls are playing lucky. 7:37 to go here in this first period. They have to sharpen up in their own zone. Can't be giving second chances to this Rain team.
No, I mean, keep in mind, this is a team that beat you back-to-back just a handful of weekends ago. Puck gets cleared down the ice. This will be an icing call on San Diego. We are still scoreless, 7.5 remaining of our first period here at the Pechanga Arena.
It's not a period the Gulls have had from Wednesday night or last night. Now, you're not going to have those periods every night. This is a period the Gulls have to work through. Hard work, and taking these icings is okay. Limit the giveaways.
Puck gets slung out to center after a San Diego defensive zone faceoff win from Carrick. He'll carry it into the offensive zone after getting a pass from Weidman. Forced to the corner and then touched out to center ice. Hawk and Pa to Weidman. Right back to Hawk and Pa. No look up. Into the center red. Fire it in. Peterson makes a glove save. He'll play it himself out and down the ice it goes. This will go for an icing call. And the Gulls will have an offensive zone faceoff. Well, looking ahead, our next big game is Hockey Fights Cancer Night. That's on Saturday, November 23rd. As the Gulls battle the Stockton Heat, 7 o'clock. Wear lavender and raise cancer awareness and bid on specialty-themed game-worn jerseys to support the Gulls Foundation and fight their cause against cancer. Get your tickets now at sandiegogulls.com/tickets. Gulls win a faceoff. Benoit tossed it towards the slot. A chance denied by Peterson on Kloos in front. Played to the blue line. Drew snapshot blocked. Rempel pulls away from the coverage of Comtois. He'll send it out to center. Benoit chucks it towards the Ontario zone. It's blocked. Comtois jamming away at it. He'll dig it loose. And Drew slides it in. We're just slowly sliding down on the time clock here. 6.5 remaining of the first. No score. At center, it's the forward Berg who's moved off the puck. Comtois hacks at it. Can't get it into the Rain zone. It's gloved down by Clegg. And he'll fish it back to the San Diego territory.
Ontario's making this game feel like you're playing in mud. They're not giving up any space. The Gulls have to fight for every foot out there in the neutral zone. It's almost like they're playing a trap. And right now the Gulls are, you know, they're getting caught in that trap right now.
Yeah, you're right. Almost quicksand, if you will. As you get caught in it too deep, you could end up fatal. Gulls drive it into the attacking zone. 5 minutes, 45 seconds remaining. Hard on the forecheck. Broadhurst, Sprong, and Pietola. Sprong pulls away, shoots wide of the net. Bounces to the near point, Seeloff. Far point for Weidman. To the near wall, Broadhurst back to Seeloff. He tried an area pass to Pietola. He tried to jam it home, couldn't. Weidman winds, fires. It's blocked in front. Another chance by Pietola. Blocked to the corner. There's a delayed penalty on the Rain. Sprong from behind the net. He tried to drive to the slot, but Peterson gave him a poke check. We'll have a Gulls JMG power play here coming up. We'll take a break and return. This is the San Diego Gulls Audio Network.
Gulls fans, it's time to announce tonight's Rebel of the Game. Please welcome Jedi Hall of Famer Yoda to this evening's game. Yoda was a legendary Jedi master and stronger than most in his connection with the Force. Small in size, but wise and powerful. He trained over 20,000 Jedi during his 800-year career. He played an integral part in the role in the Clone Wars and fought bravely with such villains as Count Dooku and Darth Sidious. He went on to train Luke Skywalker and unlock the path to immortality. Yoda's joined this evening by his young Padawan apprentices. Fans, let's give one more round of applause, please, to our Rebel of the Game, Master Yoda.
Great kill last night. Allowed those two power play goals from Whiteman and Whiteman. A pair of power play tallies for the defenseman, and he has the puck back in his own zone as he will collect it after the rain started off with a face-off win.
The Gulls are going back to the four forwards out there. Lundstrom's on the blue line with Whiteman.
On the kill, the rain 21st in the league, 80.5% as the puck finds its way out of the action. And 1:37 remaining of the man advantage. Still no score, 4:50 remaining of the first period.
Faceoff's going to stay deep in the rain zone as they shot that one out. It hit the glass first and then went out. The Gulls are going to make a little bit of a change here. Carrick's going to go and be taking this faceoff. Gulls need to have possession of this puck. Wait and see if Ontario's going to sit back or if they're going to continue to play aggressive.
Sutter and Carrick on the draw. Carrick wins it cleanly back. Whiteman will send it to Kloos. Down low, Comtois tuck and drag, and Peterson with the stop. He'll hang on.
Smart play by Comtois there as he picks it up. Big power forward, able to be nimble on his feet and pull that puck from the goal line back. He didn't put it between his legs, but he was quick enough. Gulls win the faceoff. Two quick passes, scoring opportunity. That's what you want to see.
Carrick back on the faceoff, another win. Back to Whiteman, a swift pass to the left wing for Lundstrom. He'll carry it down low to the circle. Back to Whiteman, cross ice, far wing. It's Carrick, centered, Kloos. Trying to go down low to the goal line for Comtois, who had his skates on the blue paint, but it's knocked away and cleared with 1:12 left of the power play.
It was a one-time pass. Carrick put on Kloos's stick. Kloos, though, didn't think it was coming, so he kind of got happy feet there. And his hands got going a little too quick. The Gulls are back on the prowl in the neutral zone.
Whiteman skating backwards to his territory to try to get some space. He's got four power play goals and two helpers on the man advantage. Six power play points, leading all Gulls players. It's cleared back down the ice. Daniel Sprong gives chase. He'll leave it for Whiteman. Fat up to Broadhurst. He'll carry it in across the line, tag it to the corner, giving chase is Sprong. He'll jump to it, send his man up against the boards. That's Stanton. It's muscled out by Broadhurst to the point man, Whiteman. 22 left of the power play. Sprong on the right circle, shoots, and a save is made. And it's poked to the corner. A clearing attempt kept in. Whiteman to Pietola. He snaps and saves it. Rebound. Went to chase the Leo's waist, who's trying to bat it out of midair, but keeps it alive. Sprong at the goal line. He'll skate away from the coverage of Anderson. Back to Whiteman. Far wing to Leo. Shoots. Blocked. It goes to Sprong. And a pad save by Cal Peterson as the power play expires. Sprong can't believe it as he puts his stick on his thighs and puts his head down to the ice.
Yeah, and he's right. Sprong still in the exact spot. He took that shot. Cal Peterson makes a blind save. He's got so many bodies in front of him, it's almost he feels the puck. Sprong takes the one-timer right there at the top of the circle in the slot. Somehow, Cal Peterson has got that puck sensory or memory. I don't know what it is. It's almost like he's got a little bit of glue on those pads for the puck.
Oh, you're 100% right about that. That's why he comes into this game with such a high save percentage despite a bad game last night. 92.7 save percentage to his name as the puck gets knocked out of play.
He's a gunslinger, right? You got to put that knight behind you. Your coaching staff believes in you. You've played every game this season. They pull you, they put you right back in. Cal Peterson, one of those horses I keep mentioning, he's a horse that you want to have in your organization.
And that coach you're talking about, Mike Stothers, the two assistants, David Bell and Yaroslav Modry, a former NHL defenseman with the Kings, right?
That's right.
Snapshot by Kupari. He gets belted by Benoit. The glass rattles behind Stolarz. Kupari gets back up. He'll take it to the high circle after a pass was sent his way in the bottom of the circle, but a shot gets blocked and forced out. 2.5 remaining of the first. The Gulls leading, shots 11-8, but still no one has found the back of the net. Chase DeLeo unable to get it out of his own zone. That could hurt. The Gulls recoup, and Benoit will chuck it out. Love down by Anderson. He couldn't get it out. As Alex Dosti does great work on the forecheck. Jack Kopacka carries it down low with the chance. Anderson blocks it. And Chase DeLeo will track it down in the corner. He gets pushed by two different players. It's worked free to Dursey. He'll go behind the net for Anderson to the far side. It's in the feet of the Ontario forward, Asamon. He couldn't get it out. Kept in. Jack Kopacka, left circle in front for Chase DeLeo. But he got covered and tangled up. Rimshaw play it out to center ice. Down to 1:40 remaining of the first frame. Still no score. This one's been back and forth. Doty gets driven up against the boards by Seeloff, and it's worked free by the Gulls' veteran defenseman. Kloos will blaze through center. He'll break it in. Far wing shoots, and a save made by Peterson, who freezes.
Oh, the seesaw momentum of a hockey game. The last 4 to 5 minutes, the Gulls have taken it to Ontario. After that power play, they've continued to have that puck in the offensive zone. The Gulls had a full shift where the puck's in Ontario's zone, but it was for one reason. Alex Dosti by himself, as his line's making a change, stays out there and is able to fight against two different Ontario Reign teammates and have a full line change. Alex Dosti showing a lot of heart and grit.
Faceoff win by the Reign, cleared out. Weidman backpedaling. He'll go to Lundestrom, but return back into his own zone to Ruggiero. Long stretch pass up to Justin Kloos. Trying to touch it through center to Lundestrom, but it's blocked away by Sutter. I've noticed that Sutter has been more active in his own zone and helping out the defense tonight.
Yeah, as they're putting three guys down low, each centerman is pretty much dropping back as a defenseman. I almost want to call it a 3-2 they're playing right now, defensive-wise.
Yeah, you're right about that. 50 seconds remaining of the first period. Kloos sacrificed his body to get a pass up to Lundestrom, but he brought it in offside. Our next midweek game will be the Wednesday right before Thanksgiving as the San Jose Barracuda come to town. That's 2-for-5 taco night, courtesy of Rockin' Baja Lobster. 2 street tacos for just $5 every Tuesday and Wednesday home game.
You talked about Justin Kloos sacrificing his body. Justin Kloos has probably taken 4 main hits tonight, and that time there, he had to wait for his teammate to get into open space, but that's the toughness. You don't always have to be a fighter. You have to wait a little bit to make the play, knowing you're going to take the hit.
Well, he had one here earlier. I think it was the Colorado series where he got decked. And he got back right out there on the next shift.
Yeah, Justin Kloos, he's one of those guys, for as big as he is, you think he's like Mike Tyson out there.
Yeah, and Justin Kloos, a guy who isn't your tallest player on the team by any means, 5'10", 175, but very low center of gravity. I guess that's the nice way of saying he's got powerful legs.
He's got powerful legs, and he's got a big heart is what that means, yeah. You know. Care how big they are. Justin Kloos is one of those guys. A lot of heart. Love to have a teammate like that. You need 20 of them to win.
Boy, talk about heart for his Minnesota teams as well. Vikings, big Vikings guy, and University of Minnesota as well.
That Vikings defense, we'll see how they do tomorrow night. I've got them in my fantasy.
Uh-oh. After an offside whistle, we're going to have a fight. Maybe Rempel and Comtois, and a Reign player, Ledoux, jumps in. Meanwhile, you got everybody grabbing a player. Bjornfoot and Kloos almost taking center stage, but nobody drops gloves. Hakanpaa's in there as well. He's got Rempel, who was the original agitator. And one thing, I didn't mention this on the previous faceoff, but Rempel was getting a little feisty with Blake Pietola. Rempel, you know, when you line up, you're supposed to have your right skate to the other guy's left skate. Rempel's right skate was past Pietola's right skate. And Pietola took a little bump to him, and Rempel almost gave him a high stick right in the face.
It sounds like the same thing that just happened here. It's a faceoff in the neutral zone, so it's one of those faceoffs, it's not that big a deal. But what Rempel did this time is he gave a little kick with the back of the foot to Comtois. And then as that happened, they're kind of facing off one-on-one, but Ledoux comes in there. So Comtois had two players against them, and they didn't drop the gloves, but there was, you know, face washing going on. A little bit of life left in there in this first period, 17.8 seconds ago. I don't like that the face-off deep in the goal zone.
Yeah, I don't like that, and I don't like the fact that Ledoux came in on a free haymaker on Comtois and he didn't get penalized for it.
Yeah, they're going to go 4-on-4. I think this is going to benefit the Gulls. Got Chase DeLeo out there with Daniel Sprong. These two can fly the neutral zone. Only 17 seconds, so it could be one of those Hail Marys.
And DeLeo was really good in the faceoffs last night. He'll take this one against Anderson Dolan. Hockenpah and Weidman, the two blue liners. And a faceoff win for DeLeo. That gets us going. It's played up to DeLeo from Weidman. He tried an area pass for Sprong, but Ledoux breaks it up. 9 seconds left of the period. It's played up to Bjorn Foot. He'll weave out to center. 3 seconds left. A pass behind Anderson Dolan, and that'll do it. First period is in the books. No score after last night where the Gulls were blazing with shots only held to 12. And that's actually still pretty darn good. 12-9 favoring San Diego in shots.
Yeah, and they probably got 8 of those shots in a 4-minute span late in that first period. It was slow, it was sluggish, but that's the way Ontario wants to play it. Late in that period, the Gulls started putting their speed together.
It is Star Wars night, and it's a great night here tonight at Packed Arena at Pechanga. We'll have 143 of 4-on-4 when we get back for the second period. You're listening to the Gulls Audio Network.
Gulls fans, we're here at Center Ice for an exclusive demo by the San Diego Sabres. The Sabres are San Diego's premier lightsaber training combat group.
From the start of the second period, welcome back your San Diego Gulls.
We're back inside the Pechanga Arena. The fans are getting right back into it. A packed house here tonight.
4-on-4 hockey, you got to go off the rebound. You missed the net on a 3-on-2, 2-on-1. You got to get right back on the defensive side of the puck.
Puck taken by Ledoux. He'll skate it back into his own zone. Tried to send it to the near side. It's intercepted. Weidman powers it wide. A good heads-up pass by Chase DeLeo. Kempe plays it behind the net. DeLeo lifts the stick of Ledoux. It's tracked down by Anderson Dolan. He couldn't get it out. Benoit to the far point. Keeps it alive. Carrick to Weidman. He'll step in. Hold. Still holding. He's at the line with it, looking for a seam. He'll throw it in front. DeLeo scores! Chase DeLeo gives San Diego a 1-0 lead.
Well, Chase DeLeo scores the goal, but Weidman shows poise, patience. Everybody in the building's yelling, shoot, shoot, shoot. He holds on to that puck and he waits for everybody to set up, and then he puts a saucer flip pass on the stick of Chase DeLeo in front of the net, who buries it.
Boy, who would have called that?
Well, Chase DeLeo is one of those players the Gulls need to get going, and he's a player who will be going.
DeLeo's third of the season. Still 1:05 left of 4-on-4. I can't believe the poise by Chris Weidman showing that off. Unbelievable. I would have never thought that. I thought he was getting ready to tee that one up. But that just goes to show his playmaking ability.
you know, the experience he has, and he just put it on for show there.
Strand with a chance, and Stolarz comes up with a big stop. Post to post, and by the time he stops his momentum, he's almost at the faceoff down of the circle.
Yeah, great call, Andy. He's on the post, and he feels the pressure come, and it goes over to the right slot, right on top of the circle. He makes that save, and it's a big save. And by the time he stopped, he just let the puck right out there on top of the faceoff dot.
Only one assist on that DeLeo goal. It belongs to Weidman. Lorraine with a faceoff win. I don't know if Broadhurst got chucked down to the ice or if he just threw his body and hit the deck, but he blocked the shot. Behind his own net, Weidman. Great pass up to Sherwood. He'll blaze in left wing. Toe drag, but forced to the outside by Clegg. Sherwood keeps one hand on a stick. He'll leave it at the blue line. Benoit snaps it, redirected at the last second and out of play.
Well, Benoit takes that quick shot, and what he does is he waits for that screen to go out. And I'm pretty sure the netminder there had it hit right off his head. And it looks like we got a new netminder in there for the rain. Doesn't look like it's Cal Peterson. It's still Cal Peterson. That didn't seem like the same guy to me. And that hit him in the head, and you're right, Andy. I got kind of messed up on the numbers there. That puck hit me in the head, or Cal.
Forty Peterson. We all make mistakes. I make them 20 times a game, BJ, it's okay. The fans don't know because I could be saying Lundestrom, and if they're listening on the radio, it could be Comtois for all they know. Puck gets tipped out of play. 18-14 remaining of the second. The Gulls take the lead. Here's the big thing, BJ. The Gulls getting the first goal of the game. That, to me, has been huge for success for this team. When San Diego tallies up the first goal of the game, their record 6-1-0. The only time they lost was in Stockton the very first time they were there when they scored first.
Well, they had to wait for the goal tonight. They don't have the barrage of shots like they had last night. But one thing for the shots they do have, a lot of quality shots in the few numbers taken.
Those quality shots are shots which is what's called in the house in hockey. And that's face-off dot to face-off dot down to the mouth of the net. Gull's not able to work it in cleanly. Cross-ice feed from Anderson to Rimple. He'll drive it in. Stolarz out of the net. He'll sweep it to Seeloff. Tipped up to Klus on the left wing boards. Stepping up is Strand to keep it alive, but the Gulls try the near wing. Comtois takes it to the far wing, and Klus will backtrack to Hakanpää. Fed up to Lundestrom. The Swede weaves his way into the attacking zone. He'll tip it to the corner and allow his teammates to get a change. Puck kept alive at the point by Benoit. His shot blocked to the corner. Strand jumps to it. He'll fish it off to the near wing. Drew tried to step up, but Rimple pokes it away. Down the ice it goes. Not far enough for an icing call. Benoit back in his own zone at the hash marks. Fed up to Moran, who received it behind him. Pulls it to the forehand with the drive, and Peterson makes the stop. It's played out to center. Swiftly brought by Kupari. He'll have to pull back after his initial pass was blocked. He'll play it to his line mate, Boma, and it's driven into the crowd for a souvenir.
Moran really had the right game plan as he caught over the blue line there, and he comes in. He's looking to make that pass, but everybody's covered. And again, if your last resort's taking a shot, that's a good resort. And he took that shot, and he put it high up. Cal Peterson, being such a big goalie, he was able to get down in the butterfly and still use that big shoulder blade of his to stop that last shot.
Musco leads the world in sports and large area lighting, designing LED solutions for everything from neighborhood fields to professional stadiums to international airports. Musco is proud to be the official lighting partner of the Gulls. Go to their website, musco.com, to learn more. Broadhurst with it at center. He'll break it in, far wing, snap it wide of the net. Puck carries out to center ice. Sodergren races to the San Diego zone, puts it on. Stolarz kicks it aside. Puck cleared to the slot, a few hacks at it. Berg and Grimshaw, but neither one of them could drive it past Stolarz, and it's cleared out. Almost four gone to the second, 1-0 San Diego. That was a goal off of the stick of DeLeo from Weidman. Puck gets iced by San Diego. We'll have a faceoff back in their zone.
Well, I like the way Ruggiero, as he's making that lead pass, because he's putting it through the middle of the ice, he put that like a slap shot. It missed the Gulls tape-to-tape pass, but what happens is it doesn't get left out in the middle of the ice. It goes down for an icing. Anytime you put the puck in the middle of the ice, it better have a lot of speed on it. Ruggiero did a good job with that.
Face-off win for the Rain. Clegg sets up a wrist shot that's blocked. He follows it up, adds another one, but it hit Doty's skate. That's where Ruggiero will grab it. His AHL debut, he'll sling it off the far boards. Couldn't drive it into the Ontario zone. Anderson Dolan caught up to on the back check by Broadhurst. That'll disrupt the offensive threat for the time being. Anderson Dolan will chuck it behind the San Diego net. Driven free. Weidman tips it off the far boards. Back on it is Asimont. His drive turned away by Stolarz, and that'll pave way to a San Diego penalty with the slashing call being assessed on Kiefer Sherwood.
Yeah, Kiefer Sherwood fighting down below one-on-one. He kind of loses a little bit of, you know, body language there. He gets pushed out in front. He loses his momentum, and as he's fighting back, that stick gets out of his hand. And again, you're supposed to have full control of your stick at all times. That stick got up a little bit. 15:29 to go here in this second period. The Gulls came out with a little bit more speed. It's kind of slowed down again. Gulls got to start it with the faceoff here. Sam Carrick on his backhand.
This is the first penalty kill of the night for San Diego. As the puck gets cleared by Benoit off the glass and over the glass, so no penalty there. It'll just be another faceoff in the San Diego zone. The Gulls penalty kill, sitting 16th in the league, 82.7%, while the Ontario power play is 22nd, 13.3%. Last night, the Gulls killed 3 of 4. They had a shorthanded goal, courtesy of Sam Carrick. Ledoux from the point, far wing, a one-timer by Bjornfoot, denied, and a rebound sailed wide. Anderson Dolan tried to play back to the far point. It's picked off by DeLeo and cleared down the ice. 20 seconds gone already off the kill. 1-0 San Diego, 5 gone out of the second. Anderson Dolan up to Ledoux. He'll sidestep Comtois, feed it across the line for Kempe, but an offside whistle on the Rain, so a big break for the Gulls, disrupting the Rain rush.
It is a big break for the Gulls, but the Gulls are the ones that caused it. Hockenpah and Benoit are not giving up that blue line. The Gulls' two forwards did a good job of muddying up the middle of the ice, forcing everything to the sides. And as the two defensemen hold up on that blue line, Ontario has to make that extra move, thus making the faceoff outside, and the Gulls got another chance to get that puck out.
Loose on the faceoff against Sutter. Sutter wins it because the wingman Kupari helped him on the draw. It's cleared into the far corner of the San Diego territory, but Weidman to Comtois swiftly down the ice.
Yeah, little quick communication between Weidman and Comtois made it look easy.
Clegg back in his own territory. He'll scamper in across the line, feed Sutter, wrist shot, Stolarz with the save, and a big rebound collected by the defenseman Dursey. He sends it wide. Recollected by San Diego. Seeloff powers it off the far glass. Batted down by Dursey cleanly, but it trickles into the San Diego zone. A free biscuit for Seeloff. He'll trade it to Weidman. And Weidman will lob it down the ice. 38 seconds left of the kill. Just about 6 gone in the second. San Diego leading by a score of 1-0. That goal came here early in the second period by Chase DeLeo. While the teams were skating 4-on-4, you have Justin Kloos, shorthanded breakaway. He shoots, scores! Are you kidding me? I cannot believe this. Another shorthanded goal for San Diego.
You can almost feel that the Rain were sitting back playing more defense on this power play than they were power play. I know that's a little bit of an oxymoron, but you can feel it up in the stands. As soon as the Gulls get that puck down in their zone, Kloos breaks for the neutral zone. Comtois banks one off the boards. Kloos comes down, from his forehand to his backhand. But what he does on his backhand is he doesn't put it back against the grain. He puts it up top. Forehand, backhand, up top. Another shorty by the Gulls.
12 seconds left of the kill. You can almost classify it as a power kill for San Diego. Ledoux tries a snapshot. It's blocked to the corner. We're back to even strength. Kiefer Sherwood's out of the box. Puck scrambled towards the slot. Stolar is able to keep it away. Lundestrom pulls it from the black uniforms and clears it safely out to center. He wanted to get that one deeper so the Gulls could complete their line change, but it looks like they're doing just that as Rempel will carry it back the other way. He is guarded by Hakanpaa. Now Kopacka, good body up by Jack Kopacka to knock it free. He'll get it to Moran, who clears it out. Anderson Dolan feeds it up to Asamont. Right wing side, a bullet of a shot by Rimshaw. Save made by Stolarz and Benoit and Rimshaw. Kopacka gets a few jabs as well. Boma grabs Kopacka, who's just trying to get free.
I think the Ontario team is trying to get a spark going any way they can, and Benoit doesn't bite. He sits back and patient again.
We're live from the Pechanga Arena, but we're going to step aside. 2-0 San Diego, a shorthanded goal from Justin Kluse, giving the Gulls that lead with 12:50 remaining of the middle frame.
All right, Gulls fans, it's time to play a special Star Wars edition of Spin to Win. Spinning our slot machine tonight is Supreme Leader Kylo Ren. If you get all five in a row, you get this Gulls Star Wars jersey. If you get 4 out of 5, you still are going home with a Gulls prize pack. Okay, Supreme Leader, are you ready to spin? All right, hit it. Let's see what you're going to win tonight. Oh, it's looking pretty good. Oh, all right, you got all five. You just won this Gulls Star Wars jersey. Congratulations, and thanks for playing Spin to Win.
Chongo Arena, 12:50 remaining, second period. 2-0, Justin Kluse picks up a shorthanded goal. Eric had one last night. The stat line, Comtois and Weidman pick up the assist. Chris Weidman's on pace for another three-point game.
Well, Weidman shows up on the offense. But you gotta remember, he got that point killing the penalty defensively.
And the announcement on the goal will bring the fans to a good rousing round of applause. Asamon at center collects the puck after the Gulls at a defensive zone faceoff win. Sprong gets hooked at center going after a loose puck. Strand will sit for two as the JMG power play heads to the ice to look to extend it even further.
Another one of those keys to the game. One-on-one battles in the neutral zone. Daniel Sprong fights for that puck. Has the Ontario defenseman have to break the rules and take him down? Well, the Gulls are going to try and get one this time on the power play.
Faceoff will drop to the left of Peterson. Gulls 0-for-1 on the man advantage tonight.
There's a little bit of an argument going on here. Or maybe not an argument, but the Gulls are wanting the faceoff on the left side. And the reason they want that is that's the backhand side for the faceoff. The linesmen are saying on the left side, looks like the Gulls are going to win that argument and battle. They're not only doing it during the 60 minutes, they're doing it afterwards as well.
So the faceoff will go to the right of Peterson. It'll be on the left side of the, oh, no, never mind.
Oh, looks like a referee comes in and overrules the other referee and both linesmen.
So now you got to have a new centerman, maybe. We'll see if DeLeo's still on to take it.
If he does take it, he's not going to take it on his power side. Now it's going to be on his forehand side. And even worse, Sutter on his backhand.
Yep, that's right. But DeLeo able to win it to the boards. Great faceoff. Sprong, one-timer pad save, rebound by DeLeo, blocked by Bjornfoot inadvertently. Sprong again, teeing him up, and a save made by Peterson.
Sprong's just standing over there on the top of the circle with his stick half-cocked. He's not even moving. He's got that stick sticking out there and widening and setting him up perfectly. Sprong's taking two big one-timers. He's looking to the bench right now asking, should I just stay on the blue line here or should I keep going up as a forward? Because I want to get back to my sweet spot here. It's almost like a three-point shooter in basketball.
Yep. Well, I mean, that's back in the day, like, when you had Ally Afraidy on the blue line, Al McInnis on the blue line, where those guys would just tee them up left and right in a shooting gallery. Weidman to DeLeo, down low to Sprong at the goal line. Back to DeLeo, no hold. Weidman holds, shoots, ricochets wide. Not out of the zone, Bjornfoot. Weidman will go to the far wing, DeLeo slap pass down low to Sprong, he redirected it, but wide. Great win in the corner by DeLeo, push to the slot. Jam shot denied by Peterson. But let's backtrack a moment, BJ. Chase DeLeo outbodying the Rain player to get the puck.
Paul Ledoux, 6'2", 210 pounds. Talk about low center of gravity. Talk about whatever you want. I talk about that, the fight to win. Chase Ledeo in that corner there, he man-to-man bodied up with Ledoux and won that battle, able to pick up that puck, get it behind that net. Again, it's the little things that make the big picture easier. And what Chase Ledeo did there was he won the one-on-one battle with heart.
1:19 left of the power play, 2-0 San Diego. Still trying to find their first power play goal of the game. Carrick Comtois, Lundestrom, Klus, and Weidman. Power play unit, faceoff win by the Rain, cleared down. Weidman has played both power play units on each power play tonight. Carrick weaves his way in, shoots wide of the net, and it rolls out to center. Weidman's got a hustle, he's got Asamoah on his back. Weidman will chip it to the corner. Lundestrom scoops it up, 48 left of the power play. Isaac Lundestrom works his way in across the line. He'll pull back. It's played straight away. Weidman fakes the clapper. He'll send it to the circle for Lundestrom. Far circle, Klus. Klus down low, Lundestrom one-timer. Peterson makes the save. Lundestrom will cycle for Comtois. He tried to play behind the net and ricocheted off the boards to the side of the net and cleared. 19 left of the power play.
Some good tape-to-tape passing there. A little bit of a triangle play. Lundestrom was the last man to get that puck. He one-times it. Cal Peterson makes another big save.
A few things I'm rooting for here tonight. Chris Weidman trying to go three consecutive games with 3 points as Hunter Drew shuffles it on net. Peterson gloves and hangs on. And another stat, but it's still a long time coming.
Well, I'll tell you, Weidman had an opportunity early in that last shift to take a big slapper. He did the smart play and not take the shot. The reason was no goal was in near of the net. So Cal Peterson was coming out ready for that shot. It was a smart, unselfish play by Weidman. Don't take that shot, wait, and let's focus on making a better shot. Again, the little things that don't come on score sheets that Weidman's been doing.
Well, we're having a great time here at the Pechanga Arena. 2-0 San Diego lead, Star Wars night. And a packed house full of America's finest fans. Moran swings it around to the near point man. That's Benoit. Benoit skates the line, feeds it to Drew, a one-timer and a save made by Peterson. Moran wins out a board battle. He's able to put Stanton down and center it. A drive gets blocked and another chance ends up on the stick of Doty, who slings it into the goal zone. Benoit attacks it off the near boards. Uh-oh, miscommunication, but good pickup by Drew. He'll skate in, right wing side, shoots, and a save made by Peterson. That one would have been a little bit more off to the side. That would have snuck over his shoulder.
Well, the game plan for the Gulls are take those shots from out far, got to get them up high, and that's what they're doing.
We've crossed over the 10-minute mark of the second, 2-0 San Diego. Sherwood, great protection of the puck in his own zone. He left it to deliver a body check on Sutter, and it's cleared out by Carrick. Dupari touches it in his own zone as it's whistled on a hand pass. 2-0 San Diego. Will return in a moment from the Pechanga Arena on the Gulls Audio Network.
Hi, I'm Luke Gazdick. It's time now for Gulls Trivia. Tonight's theme is Star Wars. Who wore Mandalorian armor that could withstand even blaster fire? Was it A, Stormtroopers, B, Darth Vader, C, Boba Fett, or D, the Imperial Guards? The answer is C. Boba Fett and his bounty hunter father, Jango Fett, both wore Mandalorian armor. What was the given name of the evil emperor? Was it A, Darth Sidious, B, Sheev Palpatine, C, Count Dooku, or D, Vladimir Putin? The emperor, also known as Sith, named Darth Sidious, was first given the name Sheev Palpatine, the center of Naboo. Who are Rey's parents? A, Luke Skywalker and Mara Jade, B, Han Solo and Kira, Han's first love, C, Han Solo and Leia, D, filthy junk traders from Yaku? The answer is still unknown, but is set to be revealed in the upcoming film, Star Wars, Rise of Skywalker. Thanks for playing Gulls Trivia. May the Force be with you, always.
We're back at the Pechanga Arena. A 2-0 San Diego lead. Gulls wearing their whites, green and black. Sam Carrick on the face-off circle against Sutter. Carrick wins it cleanly back. An really characteristic thing to talk about is a big factor of the game, but the face-offs tonight for San Diego have been extraordinary. Puck gets bumped into the San Diego territory. Sutter tried to center, broken up. DeLeo to Hakanpaa. He'll lob it down the ice. Sam Carrick, ooh, he almost got interfered with there, but they're going to let him play. As Ledoux stepped in his path, and then Carrick gives him a good shove off the puck. It finds Sutter, who wildly throws it over to the near wing for Boma. He'll scoot to center, slip it into the goal zone. Seeloff finds it behind his own net. He'll go to DeLeo, to Hakanpaa. The Finn drives it into the offensive zone. Head to the bench for a line change. Everybody changing for San Diego. Sutter leaves it for Bjornfoot. He'll play it to the far wing for Ledoux, and it's tipped into the goal zone by Asimov. Weidman sends it up along the near boards. Clue's able to get a stick on it. We're going end to end, and very quickly with 8:22 remaining of the second. Ruggiero back in his own zone to Weidman. Fed up to Clue and tipped in. I think the Gulls would be satisfied with doing this all game long, BJ.
Well, what they're doing here is they're keeping everything to the outside. Ontario's the team that should be cutting this out. They need to get puck possession. Then again, we're not here to tell Ontario what they need to do.
That kind of goes to show a little bit of the Gulls dictating the play right now.
You're right. They're holding the puck a lot longer, the patience they have with it. And again, when they're breaking out and they put an extra man up on the rush, it's the right time. They're not gambling whatsoever. And it's the little things, the one-on-one battles, they continue to win. Just like that along the blue line, Broadhurst again playing from the inside out.
Comtois and Isamat tangle after the goals worked it away from their own zone. And a full five-man effort. Puck brought in by Sprong. He just got it hacked away at the last second by Anderson. Stanton and Sprong exchange a few jabs, but play continues. 7:20 remaining of the second. So far in this period, San Diego owning the shot total as they have picked up 11 compared to 8 for Ontario, and an offside whistle on the Gulls with 7:11 remaining of the second period.
Yeah, Daniel Sprong, he's a player who likes to get on that score sheet. He looks like he's getting a little itchy out there, and what I mean by that is he's wanting that puck and he wants to go on the offense. A little bit of pushing and shoving, a little bit of retaliation. He's still on the ice. Looks like the Gulls are going to make a line change. That might not make him happy because he's a guy right now. He wants that puck.
Our next Wednesday game will be right before Thanksgiving in about a week and a half on the 27th. Rockin' Baja Lobster gives us 2-for-5 street tacos every Tuesday and Wednesday home game. For tickets for that game, that's going to be a fun one. Go to sandiegogulls.com/tickets. Blake Pietila pushes it on net. Peterson moves it aside. It's cleared out. Kempe overskates it. Sprong back on it. Gulls were trying to make a line change, as BJ described, but I guess it was too late for the linesman liking. And they kept this line out there, and now finally they will start to trade out players. Kempe breaks it in. A snapshot on Stolarz, turned aside. Anderson Dolan to the corner. First one on the puck. He'll weave his way to the blue line. Play it for Bjornfoot. Wide open. He shoots. And it's blocked at the last second by Hakanpää. He basically made a pad save himself. And it gets tipped out of play.
Hakanpää, the big defenseman out there, putting his body on the line for the team. The Gulls wanted that line change but couldn't get it. Yet Sprong still stayed out on that ice, maybe a little bit too long. Hakanpää makes the big save there at the end for his big netminder. Stolarz cleaning all that snow from in front of his net. 6:24 to go. The Gulls got 24 shots. Ontario's not out of this one yet with 16. They're coming wave after wave.
And that quote-unquote save was on Anderson Dolan, who has been pointless in 7 straight games. Kings don't like seeing that from a guy who is selected 41st overall in 2017. He's trying to find his own, and he's a big prospect for the Kings. Skating in his first full season. Coming out of Spokane of the WHL. Sam Carrick thought about firing the puck in. They'll give him a seam. He'll send it to the far wing, and DeLeo drives it just wide of the net. Boy, they gave Sam Carrick a bust to drive through.
Everybody thought Carrick was going to dump it in. He didn't. He holds on to it. He seamed his way through there all the way to build a quilt.
That's a good one. Gulls back in their own zone, and Hunter Drew will skate it to center and just toss it into the far corner very lightly to get everybody off the ice in a fresh lineout. 5.5 remaining. Second period, San Diego leading 2-0. That one's got me. That's a good one. I've never heard that. Antoine Morin battling behind the rain. Net squirts loose. Kopech almost jammed it short side. Morin finds it. He'll go to Dosti. It was on his offhand, so it was picked off by Södergren, who moves it behind the net. Anderson's got to get going. Boy, this fourth line is pesky for the goals. They finally elude the pressure. Sutter breaks it up. Far wing, Kupari snaps it on, and Stolarz makes a save to the corner. Sutter spins and fires another one. It goes straight to Anderson. He'll wind and fire, and Anthony Stolarz with the butterfly save.
Well, the pesky fourth line, as you call it, made a lot of noise out there and got some good scoring chances, but at the end, they played defense first.
2-0, the Gulls with the lead. Anderson with a drive blocked, and then Kempe followed it up with a shot wide of the net. Big thing that Ontario's missing is a guy by the name of Furyk, who still held out of the lineup due to a little nag of an injury. Leads the team in points and big factor, big veteran presence on that team as you have an offside whistle on the rain.
Yeah, he and a player like Imama, these are two core players. But you got to take advantage of a team when they're down like this. Believe me, over the years when the Gulls were down players, this Ontario Rain team didn't say, hey, we're going to take it easy on you tonight. Hey, when you get a team down, you keep them down. And what the Gulls are doing now is they're continuing with the same success over the last 6 out of their 7 games played that were wins.
Faceoff will drop outside the San Diego zone. Carrick against Sutter. Well, those guys got to be tired of seeing each other in the faceoff circles. Game number 4-12 between these two teams. Sherwood almost slipped in around the defense. He'll throw a body check on Bjornfoot, and then a big one comes from Sutter on Sherwood. Puck poked loose to the high slot, but it's grabbed by Kupari, who moves it out to center for Boma. He's taken off the puck by DeLeo. And the goal's speedy forward will scoot it out to center. Bjornfoot back on it, up to Boma. He'll work it in across the line. Float it wide of the net. Sutter to the corner first. He'll try to chip it behind the net. Seeloff intercepts. He gets tangled up in the corner, able to scoot it along to the hash marks for Chase DeLeo. He'll turn on the Jets, move it behind the net. Great play by DeLeo to find the wide open Weidman in the corner and elude ahead at the same time. It's back up to DeLeo. He'll work it in for Carrick. Shoots, redirected, and a pad save made by Peterson. A rebound chance by Sherwood. It's the side of the net. It's carried out by Berg for Ontario. Hockenpah disrupts his rush up ice. Pietola sends Kupari down to the ice, and he'll go to the box for a tripping call.
Anytime you take a hand off your stick and you go at an opposing player and they fall down, I think 50% of the time the ref's going to call it. Pietola's got his stick in one hand, and what he does is he gets it in between the legs of the Ontario Reign player, and as you go down on that, especially in the neutral zone, the referee calls it, and he's going to go sit down for 2 minutes.
Last time the Gulls had a penalty kill, they scored to give them this 2-0 lead. Yettle is in the box, two for Tripp. This will be the second power play of the night for Ontario. Yeah, definitely a Tripp. And actually one thing that we didn't see from our vantage point that we're seeing up on the Jumbotron was Pietola's stick clipped the skate, the back of the skate of Kupari, and sent him down to the seat of his pants. Faceoff win by Carrick. He'll play it up to Comtois. He's going to try for a shorthanded chance, and a save made by Peterson. Boy, this goal's penalty kill just all over the opposition. And they're going to do it again. Justin Clouse to Comtois. Two on one. Comtois shoots, and a save is made by Peterson. Clouse trying to keep it alive. He'll touch the puck in a penalty, I believe, on the Gulls, maybe?
Comtois is going to get a hooking call in front of the Ontario Reign net. I do not understand this call. We're not going to change it. The far referee calls it. Max Comtois, he's looking up to the Raptors, wondering how this could happen. The bad news about this is the Gulls were just inches away from getting another shorthanded goal. But what makes this worse, they're now going to kill 5-on-3 for a minute 29.
Well, here's one thing that Kevin Dineen will say following this game. You're shorthanded, and you get a stick penalty in the offensive zone. That can't happen.
You're right. And that's what he was talking about defense first. We kill these minors. Getting a shorthanded goal is nice, but that's not what we're out here to do. Do the number one thing, and that's kill.
And it's a minute and a half of a 5-on-3 kill. It starts off right. Carrick wins it to Benoit, and he'll skate to center and dump it in.
Carrick won that like there wasn't even another stick in the faceoff.
That's right. Worked in. Sutter on the left wing boards. Hockenpah, Benoit, Carrick out for the goals. A bad pass. Foot race to the puck on the far wing. Benoit with a body check gets it free for Carrick. He'll play it to Hockenpah, who clears it down the ice. And the Gulls will change out all three. That's huge. Kempe splits the defense. He'll work it in, and a big save made by Anthony Stolarz. Chris Weidman jumps on a loose puck, and he'll clear it down the ice.
Weidman really helped out there on the half breakaway, pushing the Ontario Reign to one side, having Stolarz take that side.
Weidman will get dinged on a slash as he gave Kempe a good one in the midsection. He'll go. So a 5-on-3 will continue for another minute four.
These referees really hadn't called anything in the first 35 minutes of this game. Really, in the last 2 minutes, they've had two calls, pretty chintzy ones. If you're gonna call the game one way, call it the full length of the game. Right now, the Gulls get a hook in the offensive zone. Now it's a slash in the defensive zone. Two penalties you can't have, killing penalties.
Sam Carrick on the faceoff. Hockenpah, Benoit out with him. I think the scorekeepers and everything and everyone have to get this straight.
Yep.
What will happen, penalties are going to stack. Pietola's penalty is going to expire, but he can't leave the box.
Yeah, Yeah, Pietola will have to wait for the whistle to blow, because if he's to jump on the ice right away, that'll be another penalty with too many men on the ice.
So they're making sure that the off-ice officials that open the door have that understanding. So 32 seconds left of Pietola, 104 left of Comtois, and Weidman's in for a full two. Ledoux with the puck at the blue line. They'll play it down low to Rempel, back to Ledoux. Far wing. Bjornfoot plays it down low to Kempe. Kempe works it behind the net. Rempel tried a backdoor pass. It got blocked to the corner. Bjornfoot works it down low. On the goal line, Kempe to Bjornfoot. Far circle, shoots. Stolarz the save. Big rebound. Ledoux holds, shoots, tipped out of play. Kettle is out of the box, but it stays a 5-on-3 for another half a minute.
Killing a 5-on-3, you make the triangle as small as you can, as tight as you can, sticks in the lanes, and that's what the Gulls did with good stick work, blocking any kind of pass, especially the goal mouth pass. That's what Ontario was really trying to get through there. Well, they got 31 seconds left in the second penalty, and now Weidman's will just start.
104 remaining of the second period. That's the marker right now. Sutter wins the faceoff by lunging forward on Broadhurst. At the point, it's played down low. Dersey will move it to the far wing. A shot tipped out of play. Patrick Seeloff blocking Anderson's shot out into the crowd.
Again, the sticks in the lane. Seeloff doing a great job keeping that triangle nice and tight. But when you see that shot about to take, get that stick in the lane. Second time the Gulls have been able to do that.
15 seconds left of the 5-on-3 kill, and then Comtois will be out of the box. 48 of the period. Face-off win for the Rain. Anderson to Dersey. He's straight away. Dersey down low. And a one-timer by Anderson, ricocheted wide. 5 seconds left of the 5-on-3. Dersey down low, Kupari. He'll hold at the bottom of the circle. Out of the box is Comtois. Anderson to the back door. One-timer let go by Dersey, and Stolarz comes up with a save. 5-on-3 concludes, and he still stays strong to keep it a 2-0 San Diego lead.
Well, Seeloff did the greatest job in front of that net, nullifying any kind of pass on the goal mouth. Again, Sutter sitting right at the left of Stolarz with that big paddle, wanting that puck. Seeloff, probably no gas left in the tank, ended up lying down in the passing lane. Gulls doing a lot of good jobs. 1:22 left in the last penalty.
Face off to the left of Stolarz. Boys, he looked good.
You can feel the confidence coming out every shot he faces.
Face off went for Carrick. Benoit unable to clear. 21 seconds left of the period. Anderson steps into a drive, but it's blocked to the corner. Hakanpaa sends his man down to the ice, but Dersey makes the pass to Anderson. Anderson straight away to Kempe. Far wing, quick cross ice pass, and a shot sails off of the shoulder, maybe out of play. No, it stays in. 3 seconds left, and that'll do it for the period. The San Diego Gulls kill off a 5-on-3 with authority to keep it a 2-0 lead after 40 minutes of hockey.
The Ontario Reign just getting frustrated at the end of that period. Little pushing and shoving in the corner. Simon Benoit right now standing at the gate, high-fiving each one of his teammates that just helped with that kill. This team has got it going tonight. They got to continue to do it that way, up 2-0.
You're not just a season ticket holder. You're not just a normal fan. You're part of our family. The Gulls family.
We're a giant Gulls family. Just a beautiful thing.
You're the most passionate, loyal, and vocal fans in the American Hockey League.
The unity between fans and players and the team, you don't find that a lot of places. It's just so special, the connection that we have.
We've become a family just because we love our Gulls and we love each other.
Just hockey in San Diego is fantastic.
We're also season ticket holders.
Introducing the all-new season ticket holder experience, Gulls Elite. To learn more, go to sandiegogulls.com/GullsElite or call 844-GO-GULLS today.
All right, fans, it's the start of the third period. Time to get loud and make noise. It's time for a center ice face-off.
It's Sam Carrick in the draw against Sutter. Carrick out with Benoit, DeLeo, and Hockenpah. What a formidable penalty kill. The trio, and of course, you had the foursome with Chase DeLeo, but on that 5-on-3 kill, those guys did wonderful. Kupari through center, he'll backhand it in. First one on it is Boma. It's turned right over. Sutter gave it accidentally to DeLeo, and he'll send it all the way down. Half a minute remaining of the penalty kill. Sam Carrick pressuring aggressively, killing some more time off the clock. Comtois looks on. Carrick battles it away from two different Rain players and puts it behind the net.
And he sits there and he just stays patient again. No need to bust out of that corner. Did a great job, killed at least 40 seconds.
Puck dumped into the San Diego zone. Stolarz works it out. Hockenpah and Klus, 2-on-1. Hockenpah shoots and a save made by Peterson to the near corner. Well, they all can't be winners.
No, Hockenpah comes lumbering in there, the big lumberjack, and he knew to do the right thing. Get that big shot away. Klus was pretty much standing flat-footed. Hockenpah does the right thing and gets that shot away.
We're back to even strength. 1 minute, 10 seconds old into the third period. Seeloff, nice move in his own zone around Rempel. Little spinorama action behind the net. As played up to Klus, he'll dart his way in. Klus, far wing, shoots wide of the net. The puck carries out to center for Rempel to scoop up. He'll go in on Drew, and a snapshot tipped wide in the net by the goal's rookie defenseman. Hunter Drew coming out of the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League. And an Ontario-born player, he was looked over in the OHL draft, which is why he jumped over to the Quebec Major Junior League. Making him pay. He was a very good defenseman in the queue and proved it getting to the AHL.
Well, you got to like his tenacity, you know, not to give up. If it doesn't happen in one league, get it in another.
Lundestrom through five players with a chance to save. Rebound by Pietola. He's trying to jam it home, but Cal Peterson makes the save. And boy, has he been a star tonight. Rimshaw not taking a liking to Blake Pietola's stick and the pad of Peterson. He rips it off his netminder.
Well, it's like Pietola was back on the East Coast getting rid of all that snow in the front of your house, because that was like a shovel. After the rebound sitting there, Pietola whacks away, and he's one of those goal scorers that will put the goalie in the net with the puck. I'm surprised they didn't do more to Pietola after that. That's taking a lot of whacks at big, you know, Cal Peterson. I wouldn't be too happy if I was the coach there. Three different whacks away and my goalie's down there. You gotta be showing a little bit more than that.
Right off the faceoff, Sprong sends one just wide of the net. Ruggiero from the blue line carries it back down low, chips it to the far corner, but it's scooped up and moved out. Södergren will blast it down low, go after it himself. Track it down to the corner, trying to leave it for Berg, but he touched it a little bit too far away from his stick. Scooped up by Broadhurst. Sprong broke it in, but he's forced to the outside, and the Rain will turn it back the other way. Rimshaw in across the line. He'll slam on the brakes at the top of the circle, left it for Strand, and a shot from the near boards gets turned away by Stolarz. Another centering pass blocked to the far wing. Ruggiero will drive it down the ice. Got to the center red line to clear it in. Goals with a wholesale line change. They're traveling from right to left, and Asimov tries to split the defense. And boy, one thing you don't want to do is try to get past the two heavy shoulders of Seeloff and Drew. They'll pave way to get Kopacka up. They'll snap one on, and Peterson pads it away to the corner. A loose puck taken away by the Rain, and it's sent up to the right wing side. Asimov backhands it in. Moran makes him pay with a body check. Just about 16 and a half remaining in the third period. 2-0 San Diego. I mentioned this last night when the Gulls had a two-goal lead. They had a two-goal lead two different occasions. It's just not comfortable because one error can bring Ontario within one.
Oh, there's that old saying, two-goal lead's the worst lead in hockey, mind you. I'd rather be up 2-0 than anything else.
Yeah, no, I agree. I hate that saying, too. Yeah.
It's one of those sayings, though. The reason is, do you sit back or do you keep pushing forward? What the Gulls are doing, they're playing their same game. Ontario is the team right now. They're opening up.
Yeah, they are. Sherwood gets pegged in the corner. Clean hit, though. And a shot by Clegg hits off the end boards. Another chance by Sutter, blocked by Hockenpah. He'll spring it out to center for DeLeo. Nice move, and he'll chip it over to the near wing for Kiefer Sherwood. Sherwood scoops it up on the boards. He'll curl back to the Ducks logo in the Ontario zone. Play to Ruggiero. He'll guide it behind the net for DeLeo. Centered, but it hit a skate. Sutter chops it down the ice, and it'll be an icing call in the rain. And that rain line is already breathing heavily, desperately needing a line change. Same for the Gulls. They'll get one, but the rain can't change because of the ice.
Oh, you're right. A Gulls player takes a hit in that corner, and you called it, Andy. I couldn't see who it was, but what I did see was Simon Benoit. He didn't care if it was a clean hit or not, because it was a big hit. And these are the little things. He went over to that Ontario player, got in his face, gave him a little extra shot there. These are the little things that bring teams tighter together.
Hey, just a quick reminder to fans, if you're in the Pechanga Arena right now, the concessions will close here shortly, so make sure you grab some nachos and a soda because it's delicious. Puck worked down low to the goal line. Clues try to move to cut to Peterson, but he's able to bump it loose on a poke check, and it's cleared out.
Well, that Ontario team needed to get that five-man change in a hurry.
Back in his own zone, it's the Gulls centerman Lundestrom, fed up to Weidman. He'll chop it in. Gulls will go right back with another line change. They're trying to keep it fresh here. This is the final game of six games in nine nights, keep in mind. That's one thing that kind of got lost on us here amidst all these goals that have been scored recently, taking center stage on the storyline. Chase DeLeo with a good poke check, gets it away from Kempe, the veteran forward for the rain. Regained by Sodergren, and Kiefer Sherwood just like a hair away from stealing the puck, and finally it'll force a bad pass from Ledoux. Carrick breaks it back in. He'll go to DeLeo, sent behind the net on a return feed to Carrick. He'll pull back to the far boards, wrestling against Anderson Dolan, chopped around to the near side. Daniel Sprong beat out to the puck by Berg. It's swiftly moved back to the far wing, and on the left wing side, the young star defenseman Bjornfoot will work it in across the line. He gave it to Sonnegren, who gets hacked off the puck. Blake Pietola finds it on the near boards. He'll scoot it out to center. Under 14 remaining of the third period, 2-0 San Diego. Sprong breaks in across the line on the right wing side. He'll skate across the line, stop trying to shake loose Anderson. Spun and fired, but it's blocked in front, and it's carried out by Berg, tipped in by Anderson. Seeloff tracks it down in his own territory. Leave it in the far corner for Hunter Drew. Tried to make a pass to Dosti. It hit off of a shin pad and bounces behind the San Diego net for Seeloff to secure. He'll shake loose of the forecheck. Asamot go to Drew. Long stretch pass misses Kopaka. Moran hustling but can't break up the icing call. Boy, does he have a good giddy up.
He's got a good giddy up. Hunter Drew there, mind you, a rookie defenseman. As they're playing catch, Seeloff and Drew coming up the ice. He can go another 2 feet and make that pass. And if it misses, it's not going to be an icing. Hunter Drew made that pass 2 feet too early. When you miss that pass, comes all the way back down. I can see on the bench right now, coaches were talking to him as he's going back into the play.
Faceoff dropping to the right of Stolarz. Strand for Ontario to it. Swept off the puck by Moran, and all the way back it goes. Gulls with a wholesale line change. The rain trying to catch him. One on one. Caught up to his Boma. Ruggiero is able to jump in on him and use his long reach to take him off the puck. It's kept in by Strand at the blue line. A wild shot bounces off the skate of Carrick. Moran racing after it, but he's beat out barely by Strand to the puck in the Ontario zone. Strand will play it to Kupari. He'll break it in with a shot blocked wide to the corner, and a great play by Weidman. You won't see that on the stat sheet, but he tangled up Boma as he was going to the net. Boma almost tried to put that in off the end boards, but Weidman held him the entire way.
Weidman was reading that the whole way. It's one of those plays he's probably seen 100 times and didn't bite for it.
Sherwood powers the puck into the attacking zone. Coming out's Peterson. He gets challenged. It's hacked away from his stick. Carrick has to pull back to the corner, though. He'll cycle for DeLeo. He gets pinned up against the boards by Clegg, and it's worked out to center. Around Benoit is Kempe. He'll dump it in. Stolarz comes out of the net. A soft play off the boards. Kempe blocks it. Rolls to the feet of his line mate, Rempel. Pulled away by DeLeo, and he'll dart to center. Fire the puck into the attacking zone. It takes a big Gulls bounce. Goes right to Lundestrom. He's centered, but it's skipped over the stick of Klus to center. Carried up by Rimshaw with a shot feeding on the right wing. Easily patted away by Stolarz. Puck jarred away by Justin Klus. He'll lead it up to Comtois. He'll break it in on the right wing. Comtois hits the brakes. Cross ice to Lundestrom. Drop back to Seeloff with the drive, but blocked by Sonnergren and out of play. Back in a moment from the Pechanga Arena. This is the Gulls Audio Network. We're back inside the Pechanga Arena. Ledoux breaks it into the San Diego zone. A soft shot turned away by Stolarz. Back to the point. Bjornfoot lets a rocket go. Stolarz gets interfered with. There is a penalty on the rain. Chris Weidman taking exception to Bjornfoot letting a shot go.
You can't have your valuable asset, Stolarz, getting manhandled like that.
Gulls to the JMG power play for 2 minutes. This is pretty big. Yeah, the Gulls are up 2-0, but you got to push this lead a little bit further. Face-off win, Weidman. He could be the guy to do it. He's held goalless tonight, which is shocking the way he's been playing. To Hakanpaa, far wing for Lundestrom. Lundestrom on the corner. He'll find Weidman, one-timer powered off the corner of the boards. How does that stick in play? I've never seen that.
That puck went about 500 feet in the air. Everybody thought it went through the boards.
Back out to the near point, Weidman. And the thing is it stayed in the air for probably about another 5 seconds and bounced on the far half wall. Carrick forces a man down on the ice. It's pulled away, cleared out to center ice, barely away from Hakanpaa. He was able to bat it down on a midair. That clear was from Stanton. Hakanpaa showing off his hand-eye coordination. Puck cleared back down. Ooh, and a punch. That'll be a penalty. Asamont delivered a punch to the San Diego forward, Max Comtois.
Well, you would want to give this puck up. You want to go to the 5-on-3. The Gulls are coming up right now. Smart play getting that in and having them touch the puck.
Ledoux touches it. Comtois to the bench. Should be good, but he took a pretty good hack. He went in to go finish a check on Asamont, who delivered a swinging uppercut. Chris Weidman is not happy. There's what you like, BJ.
That's what you like. Weidman not happy with the little chintzy shot. Even though Ontario's getting a 2-minute minor, he's still letting his team know, you're not going to take liberties like this against our team. And he's the one leading the charge over at the bench. Coaches aren't even talking right now. It's Chris Weidman over there. And again, Comtois will take that punch every day of the week if it leads to a power play, especially a 5-on-3. Let's see the difference the way Ontario did it and the way the Gulls did. And what Coach Kevin Dandine is doing right here is a smart play. Take the time out. The guys you wanted on the power play were out there. Give them a little extra rest.
So on 49 seconds of a 5-on-3.
Well, we talk about the faceoff being so crucial. This is one of those times. 5-on-3. Look at the way Ontario lines up. They line up a man out of the play. They're going 100% needing this win.
Face-off win by Sutter, but the puck kept in at the point. Weidman trades it to Klus. Down low to the goal line, Lundestrom. He shoots, hits the side of the net. Sprong gives chase to the near boards. He and Klus work it low. Sprong will play back out to the point for Klus. Straight away, Weidman. He and Klus trade places. Down low, Lundestrom to Klus. Down low, Sprong. Straight away to Weidman. Back to Sprong. He'll hold at the faceoff dot to Klus. He'll fake the slapper, step in, shoots, and a save by Peterson. Carrick to the corner. He'll guide it to Sprong. He'll cut straight up the gut. Try a shot blocked by Sutter. Sprong retrieves. He'll play it to Lundestrom. Now to Weidman. 5 seconds left of the 5-on-3. Klus to Lundestrom. He shoots. It's blocked wide. 5-on-4 power play. Uh-oh, Weidman has trouble with it. And a wise play. He'll send it all the way back into his own zone.
Let his team get a line change. They're going to get the puck. Still got the 5-on-4. Again, that's a play you don't ever see. You don't see guys being that smart making that play. Weidman, with the pressure going his way, holds that puck and waits for his troops.
8.5 remaining of the game. 2-0 San Diego. Puck cleared back down on the ice. San Diego has 40 seconds left of power play time as Stolarz leaves it for Weidman. 2 assists for him tonight. Great pass up to Broadhurst. Still chipping in around coverage. Grab it in the corner. Tried to go back to the point. Eventually gets it to Drew after a stick check. Sent to DeLeo with the hash marks. Broadhurst down low behind the net. Back out to the point man, Drew. Near side for Weidman. Cross ice, DeLeo. Down low to Broadhurst. Back to DeLeo. Drew straight away. Return to DeLeo on the right circle. Down low to Broadhurst behind the net. He'll send it out to the left point for Weidman. He'll chop it down low to the corner for DeLeo. We're back to even strength. Power play for the Gulls is over. Broadhurst turns it over, and he regains it, stealing a pass from Anderson Dolan. It's played up to Pietola. Clicked off his skate, goes to DeLeo. He'll backhand it in on Peterson, who gloves it down. Kupari cross ice feed to Sodergren. Sidesteps a poke check of Moran. Great play. He'll move it up to Rempel. Breaks it in. Can't get around a poke check of Hockenpah. Good, strong defensive play. Rempel again out to the point. Clegg winds up a drive and scores. 2-1 the score. Anthony Stolarz's shutout bid concludes.
Well, Stolarz has pretty much stopped everything tonight. But as the Ontario defenseman's able to walk in from the blue line, cut across the top of the circles, he winds it right up and drops that in the net. Hard for Stolarz to stop everything as they're coming one after another. Klug fires that one top shelf. 7-11 to go in this third period. Still a lot of time to go.
Second-year defenseman Cale Clegg's third of the season. Last year he had 7-52 games. Talked about the prospects that the Kings have here in Ontario. He's one of them, a second rounder in 2016. And now all of a sudden, this is uncomfortably close. And the game far from over. We'll have a good finisher here at the Pechanga. Sherwood steals a pass from Clay. Gets played to Carrick, who shoots, but wide of the net. Rolls off to the half wall, kept in by Seeloff. He'll chip it down low for Sherwood at the corner. He cycles for DeLeo, cycled once more for Carrick. Centered Sherwood, he got high sticked. There'll be a penalty on the rain. Sherwood plays it back to the point. Drew's shot redirected by Carrick, but just wide. And it is taken in the near boards. Lundestrom down low to the half wall for DeLeo. Back to Lundestrom. All the way over to the far wing for Sherwood at the hash marks. His pass blocked to the near point. Lundestrom's like, you know what? I'm going to curl back and we're going to reset. 6.5 remaining. Lorraine can't score if they don't have the puck. Puck brought in by Sherwood. His shot blocked. Carrick retrieves on the far boards. Great patience. He'll roll it back to the blue line. Drew, near wing, Lundestrom. Cruises to the slot and a backhander. Boy, that was blocked and a quick whistle from the referee. You should have possession. He gives Lorraine a gift.
You're right, Andy. Should have a little bit of control there.
2-1 lead for the Gulls, 6:07 left, and the power play coming your way when we get back on the Gulls Audio Network. We're back inside the Pechanga Arena, a JMG power play for the Gulls to try to get back on a two-goal lead. Weidman one-timer right off the draw, wide of the net. Drew winds, fires at a save made by Peterson. Weidman shuffles it down low for Comtois, played it between his legs. Unfortunately, went right to Kempe, who sails it down the ice. Under 6 to go of the third. 1 minute, 35 seconds left of the power play. Drew through center, plays it to Comtois, cross ice. He's able to get it to Lundestrom. He could move it down low. It's broken up and cleared. Forrest pass resulted in that one.
Yeah, Comtois, as he's putting that pass across, you'd like to see that a little deeper. Don't be playing 5 feet on that blue line.
And that's got everybody's momentum going forward, so if that's picked off, you could have a potential break the other way. Puck ricocheted in. All the way around to the point man, Weidman. Now to DeLeo, left circle. He'll play to the goal line, skips away from Sprong. It's collected by Hockenpah on the far boards. 56 left of the power play. Hockenpah around to the near side for Sprong. Sprong tries to file it through traffic, but Camp is blocked and backhanded out. Weidman will lay it up for DeLeo and an offside whistle on the Gulls. 41 seconds remaining of the power play.
Yeah, Daniel Sprong, he's one of those players. He's a goal scorer, he's a shooter. There's not a chance on the ice anywhere where he doesn't like to take that shot. A lot of times on the power play, guys are trying to work it. Daniel Sprong's one of those guys. You give me that puck, I'm gonna be taking shots. There's still 41 seconds to go here on the power play, 4:48 to go in the game. If the Gulls aren't able to get this power play goal going, they got 4 minutes to kill to get the rest of this game out.
This is a little uncomfortably close with the way the Gulls have had this game. I think the score definitely doesn't dictate, but Ontario's here. 2-1 the score. Sprong breaks it in, scores! Daniel Sprong gets a gift. He was trying to play it to the far post, mishandled it, hit a skate, and goes in the back of the net. That's the break you need.
That's the break you need, and when you work hard, good things happen. The bounces go your way. I was just talking about Daniel Sprong not having a spot on the ice where he doesn't like to shoot. Well, you know what? That really wasn't a shot. Maybe he was putting it into the neutral zone or the slot for a teammate. Either way you look at it, it hits off the skate of the Ontario player, and Daniel Sprong skating up the middle of the ice. I was just waiting for him to put the stick between his legs and ride that stick.
Five game goalless drought for Daniel Sprong has ended. I almost thought he was gonna go down to his knees.
It was
that.
Coming, he was throwing the glove in the air, gonna be shooting it. We have no idea what was gonna happen.
He was getting ready for something. Well, you want to talk about monkeys getting off your back. Daniel Sprong last night, 9 shots and couldn't get one through. Here tonight, he has been firing them on all cylinders again. Finally gets one through to give San Diego a 3-1 lead. That's shot number 6 for him.
15 shots in 2 games. That's a goal scorer.
Jack Kopacka to the corner of the Ontario zone. Swing around in the near corner, still with the puck. Fought down low to Dosti, back to Kopacka. Shot hits the side of the net. Moran to it. He'll go to Hockenpah. Rims it around to the near side for Benoit. The defenseman will step up to the hash marks. He'll play it back around to the far side. Södergren gets to it first, and he'll lunge it out with 3.5 remaining of regulation. Hockenpah to Benoit. Get to the center red, fire it in, rimmed over to the far wing. Justin Kloos there, chip back around to the near side. Anderson to Sutter, swallowed up by coverage. He'll force it off to the far wing. Bird cuts through center, breaks it in, near wing. Sutter shoots, blocked. Great play in his defensive zone by Patrick Seeloff to make sure number 7's shooting lane is clogged, and it just misses an empty net. After Cal Peterson joined the team up ice, heading to the bench for the extra attacker. 3-1, San Diego with the lead, under 3 to go. The net is empty for the rain. Weidman pushes his man up against the boards. That's Kempe. It's worked free for Sutter. Sutter to the far corner of the San Diego zone. Work back for Bjornfoot. Near side, Dursey. He had a goal last night, his first one of his pro career. Back to Sutter, and a slapper gets turned away. Dursey to Bjornfoot, back to Dursey straight away, shoots, and a stop made by Stolarz. Puck scooped up by Kupari. He'll try to fight it loose from Kloos, can't do so. It's taken by Lundestrom. He's forced to the corner. Lorraine trying to slowly work in a line change. Down to 2:14 remaining of regulation. Gulls lead 3-1. Puck battle worked out to the point. Ledoux holds it the line, he'll go to Dursey, back to Ledoux. Broke his stick in half. Max Comtois to it. He'll carry it to center. Feed Kloos. A lead pass for Comtois, who shoots wide of the net. He had Kupari's stick almost attached to his stomach up ice.
Yeah, Comtois wasn't too happy with the referees. He shouldn't be happy. He had a rope all around him.
Two different chances for the rain up ice by Clegg. One was stopped by Stolarz, the other hit the side of the net. And now it's cleared out by Comtois. Sherwood jumps to it, to the empty net, scores!
Kiefer Sherwood buries that puck, but you don't like the way he went into the net on the same play. He buries it, but yet his don't like the way he's hobbling around. That knee of his went and took the net right off the moorings. Kiefer Sherwood being helped off the ice right now by Simon Benoit. We're gonna get to see on the replay here. Kiefer Sherwood does what he does. He beats the one-on-one, and as he's coming in, he loses his momentum, falls to the ice, and I don't like the way his leg was cocked back, kind of behind him there. Hopefully this is just a stinger. The Gulls need to keep these good times rolling.
Well, Kiefer Sherwood picks up the empty netter. He'll pocket his sixth of the season. Face off at center, Braunhurst against Rimshaw. 1:29 remaining. Shooting the puck in is Södergren. After it, Seeloff rims it around very hard with authority, and down the ice it goes for an icing call.
Well, Seeloff just fires that puck around. It's about 2.5 minutes ago when there was a lot of action in front of Stolarz that Seeloff made one of the bigger plays in this game that we didn't get to talk a lot about. It was a two-on-one where he put his body, and when I say his body, he went chest first and made the block save for Stolarz. Seeloff has done a lot of good things tonight defensively.
Faceoff win for the rain, but played down low by Stanton, cleared back out. Carried up by Södergren. He'll drive it into the goal's territory. Sprong from Hakkapan, Pietila, and then Sherwood from Comtois round out our scoring line. Sprong in his own zone to Braunhurst, 40 seconds remaining. Braunhurst works it in center. Pietila sends it wide. A rebound goes to the slot for Drew. Shoots and scores! Holster that stick, Hunter Drew. It's 5-1 San Diego.
Wow, Hunter Drew, the 50 goal scorer. He puts that one in the top shelf. He spins that stick down with authority. You called it there, Andy, the way Hunter Drew just did that. Oh, we got some yapping at the bench. Ontario doesn't like this. They feel they're being disrespected by the young rookie. I'll tell you what, Hunter Drew's not backing down.
Half a minute remaining. San Diego with a four-goal lead, putting the icing on the cake. What a shot by Hunter Drew to pick up goal number two on the season for him. He had that San Jose power play goal back in the second game of the year. A goal he wasn't too happy about because of the detrimental loss, and I'm sure he's a lot happier about this one than his first career pro point. 22 seconds remaining. Yanni Hakkapan back in his own zone. He'll play to the near boards for Kopaka. Back to Hakkapan. Gulls is playing catch with it. The rain are sending guys. Look out. Here comes Doty against Seeloff. Some hacks behind the play. They keep on going. Doty and Seeloff. Doty wants to go. He jumps on Seeloff. And now Rimshaw goes after Seeloff. Seeloff trying to skate to his bench. And a herd of black jerseys jump on him. Strand jumps in, Moran, Rimshaw, and Hakkapan. Hakkapan wants Boma. Antoine Moran pinned up against the boards as well. Sutter grabs Moran. Stanton.
Now a little bit of a worry here, Andy. A little too close to the Gulls bench. You don't want guys getting in.
Now you got Hakkapan, who almost broke into a fight with Rimshaw, but pulled away. Go ahead, BJ.
Well, I don't like it when it's so close to the Gulls bench. You see some of the Gulls getting their hands in the ruckus there. We're watching on the replay here. Seeloff They are pretty much swinging sticks there. Seeloff holding his own, not wanting to drop the gloves this late in the game. You can see it was right over in the Gulls bench.
Well, I also believe that fighting majors, I know in the NHL it's a case for a suspension, but I don't know about in the AHL. If you get a fighting major with under 2 minutes, could be a suspension.
Yeah, and there's no time left on the clock right now. The game is ended. Hopefully the referees don't call any fighting majors.
A goal celebrating a victory here tonight. 5-1, your score.
All right, fans, it's now time to announce this evening's three stars of the game. Tonight's third star, from the Gulls, number 3, Chris Weidman. Tonight's second star of the game, from the Gulls, number 28, Justin Klus. And this evening's number 1 star, making 28 saves, from the Gulls, number 41, Anthony Stolarz. And now, fans, let's go down to the ice where Emily Harlan is standing by with Anthony Stolarz.
Anthony, you just won your 7th straight game, which is a career high for you. You stood on your head tonight, especially on the PK. What's been working so well for you out there?
The guys are just doing a good job in front of me, just boxing guys out and letting me see the first shot, and I'm just doing my best to try to control the rebound.
And you played back-to-back games this weekend. With that kind of workload, how do you keep yourself ready and playing at the top of your game?
Just taking care of my body, always eating healthy, and just stretching after practice, making sure that everything's good to go. And this is as a goalie, this is what you want. You want to get on a rhythm here and play some games.
And anytime these two teams get together, things seem to be a little bit more physical. I think the crowd certainly felt it. How did these fans energize your team tonight?
Yeah, absolutely. The crowd was fantastic tonight, and anytime that. They had a pushback, we come right back, and, hearing the fans after we score a goal really gets us pumped up.
Anthony, thanks for the time. Congratulations on the win, and get some rest, all right?
Yep, thank you.
So the Gulls take the big victory against the Ontario Reign, and certainly a statement victory, and it seems like we're going to keep on touching on these statement victories. And one of the heartbreaking moments, though, is when Kiefer Sherwood scored that empty net goal. I mean, I've never been upset at a goal, but I could tell that he was ailing after that one, and that took him out of action for a little bit. It's very disheartening to see because he was rolling leading up to that game.
Kiefer Sherwood started the season, I think, as one of the hottest Gulls players, and I think he was red hot, ready to get called up when the Ducks needed somebody. Unfortunately, up by a 4-1 score, you can't tell a player to lighten up the game. He gets the puck, goes down the boards, and instead of just going around the net, he makes sure he gets that goal. But the problem was he took that net right out. You're right, Andy. That was a tough one.
And then Hunter Drew made that icing on the cake there too. But overall, good game. And then keep in mind, Sherwood came back and he started firing it back up right again. It hardly took him very long to get going again. And that's just kind of the will that this team displayed during the course of the year and especially during that game.
Yeah, you're right. And that shows you the will of Kiefer Sherwood to be able to come back from that injury and not take too much time to get back in action.
All right, fans, thanks a lot for watching this Friday night edition of Gulls Rewind. We'll keep moving along during the course of our best featured games, so make sure you stay attention to all of our social media channels. For BJ McPherson, my name is Andy Zilch. Thanks for watching.